Miles's prodigious young drummer, Tony Williams, had recently heard a tape recorded in London by McLaughlin, Holland, and drummer Jack de Jonette, and Williams wanted McLaughlin to join a new band he was planning. By February 1969, McLaughlin was in New York, knocking out all and sundry with a devastating performance at a jam session at Count Basie's club in Harlem. Tony Williams's boss, Miles Davis, was as impressed as everybody else, and invited McLaughlin to play on sessions for his new album a couple of weeks hence. When McLaughlin arrived, he was confronted with a new piece written by Joe Zawinul, which Miles ruthlessly edited down to its basics. Miles decided he wanted the tune introduced on guitar. He turned to McLaughlin and simply told him, "Play like you don't know how to play the guitar." The result was In a Silent Way. McLaughlin found himself being wooed by his idol. He'd come over to join Tony Williams' new group, but now the master himself was pursuing him. He stuck to his guns, though, remaining committed to Williams' group while playing on many of Miles's most significant recordings of the time, including the seminal Bitches Brew. It was on another Miles session, though, that he first worked with a young drummer who would be a significant player in McLaughlin's future, Billy Cobham. McLaughlin and Billy Cobham chumming down on Miles Davis's Jack Johnson. Tony Williams' band remained John McLaughlin's first priority, an organ trio from hell known as Lifetime, with Larry Young behind the keyboards. Interestingly enough, all three musicians had logged quite a few jamming hours with Jimi Hendrix, whom they and Miles worshipped. Lifetime were a new kind of group, with one foot in the illustrious jazz past and the other smack in the middle of rock's present. Even though they were hindered by rotten studio production, inept management, and the leader's insistence on singing, Jack Bruce called them the best band that's ever been. From the second and last album by the original Tony Williams Lifetime, that's Allah Be Praised, with Jack Bruce sitting in on bass.